Hi, I'm Phillip Slater, and this is number 4 in a series of videos about my new book, Spare Parts Inventory Management. Now, the book takes you through the entire life cycle of spare parts inventory management. So everything from establishing a spare parts inventory management system, to how many you should stock, through to managing through an operational phase, finally through to obsolescence and disposal. Now, in this short video, I just want to talk a little bit about the operational phase. See, this is the part where you spend most of your time with your spare parts inventory because you've set it up, you've actually decided what you're going to stock and how many, and then this is the period where you're actually managing that inventory for most of its life that you have it. So you need to be thinking about forecasting in terms of, well, do I still need to be holding the levels that I've got? Should I be forecasting different levels? You need to be thinking about storeroom management. How do I set up my storeroom management? How do I manage repairable items? How do I go through a system of optimization of my spare parts? What about data management? What are the things you should be looking out for in terms of data management? What about inventory accuracy? How do you establish a 100% accurate inventory? This book will show you how. I also go on to explain barcoding, and when it shouldn't be used and how it works and what it does. And then, how about integrating your spare parts inventory management with your maintenance management? See, this is one of the big disconnects in the spare parts inventory world, is the fact that maintenance and spare parts management don't connect in the right way. I'm going to show you the linkages that you need in order to ensure better spare parts inventory management.